No one cares how much you can squat with your shitty ass form, all right? Lighten up the load, go all the way down, focus on the technique. No one cares how much you can bench press, but then your hips come off the bench and you're just bouncing the bar off your chest. No one cares how much you can deadlift, but your back is hella rounded, looking like a dog taking a shit, all right? Lighten the weight a bit, focus on the right technique, and you'll be surprised how much progress you'll make and how quickly you'll make it compared to just eagle lifting all the time. What's up, everyone? David here. Got a new video for y'all today. But before we get into it, if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to the channel, hit the bell notification so you don't miss out on any new videos. Because remember, got new videos on this channel every week, specifically on Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Sundays. So do not miss out. Now, to all you beginners, I'm specifically talking to you in this video. 2024, you decided to start hitting the gym, build muscle, gain strength, lose weight, whatever it is. You have a fitness goal in mind, but you're new. You don't know what advice to take. You don't know what to do. And most likely, you're going to be making some mistakes along the way. All right. No one goes in the gym knowing exactly what they have to do on day one. We learn as we go. Sometimes you gotta jump off the cliff and learn how to fly on the way down, but there's gonna be a ways to make it fly faster, right? There's gonna be ways you can avoid making mistakes sooner. Please avoid the things that I did when I first started. So, beginner tip number one that you should definitely be avoiding is stop fucking eagle lifting, all right? No one cares how much you can squat with your shitty ass form, all right? Lighten up the load, go all the way down, focus on the technique. No one cares how much you can bench press, but then your hips come off the bench and you're just bouncing the bar off your chest. No one cares how much you can deadlift, but your back is hella rounded, looking like a dog taking a shit, all right? Lighten the weight a bit, focus on the right technique, and you'll be surprised how much progress you'll make and how quickly you'll make it compared to just eagle lifting all the time. In all seriousness, no. If you're a beginner, please prioritize your technique, okay? A lot of you, maybe you're a beginner, you're gonna have the goal of building muscle, all right? You wanna get more yoke, more swole. You're not gonna be getting that way just by loading up hundreds of pounds on the bar and just neglecting the technique. No, when it comes to building muscle, you need to feel the muscle contract. You need to lengthen it, you need to shorten it. That means you gotta go through the stretch at the bottom of the movement, you gotta contract on the way up, okay? A lot of you, you think that, okay, because you're new, maybe you feel the need to impress everyone, load up the bar more, but in reality, no one's looking at you at the gym. No one cares about how much you can lift like that, especially if you're doing it with bad form. You're just increasing the risk of you getting hurt, when instead you should be doing is lighting the weight, focus on that technique, making sure you're doing it right, and feeling the burn in those right muscle groups, okay? In reality, if you're someone who's eagle lifting and you're just loading up the weight as much as you can, chances are you're probably doing less than 5 reps. You're probably going 1, 2, 3, maybe 5 reps at most. Now, if you want to be building this muscle, aim for something safer, a little bit more appropriate rep range, such as maybe 8 to 12 rep ranges. I mean, that's what the science shows, maybe 6 to 15 if you want to go a little bit further past that 8 to 12 rep range. But stay within that instead of going just the heavy single, double, and triple sets, all right, 1, 2, and 3 reps per set. Please avoid that, all right? Again, if you just do that, especially if you're a beginner, you're loading up the bar too heavy, like I said, you're just going to hurt yourself. You should be doing higher reps as a beginner. Why? It's because you need constant practice with these new movements. If you're new to the gym, then reality is it hasn't been often that you've been practicing this movement on a pressing exercise. Reality, you haven't been practicing the squatting motion on a bar. You haven't been practicing this motion on an RDL. So you need constant repetition so your body finally gets that motion down. And how do you get the constant repetition? By constantly repeating it, and that means higher reps. So for me personally, if I were a beginner, if I were to go back to my very first day, my very first week, my very first month, I would have been doing sets of 12 to 15 reps on all the major exercises. Again, so my body gets used to moving in that pattern. And once I started perfecting the technique, then I'll start focusing on maybe adding a little bit more weight and kind of decreasing the reps a little bit so that at the end, I'm comfortably hitting some good hard working sets of 8 to 12 rep ranges. Because realistically, heavy weight, bad form, that's just a recipe for disaster. You're just gonna fuck yourself up. And then on top of that, I would like to point out, just because I feel like it falls into this first tip, is do not rely on all this different supportive gear, all right? You see all these people wearing all these wraps, all these belts, and specifically beginners, okay? Those of you who are wearing all this stuff, please, please, please avoid it. Nah, you're doing nothing. Like, for example, there's this guy on Instagram that I've been seeing, El Campeón, all right, the champion for you non-Spanish speakers. He is the prime example of what I'm talking about to avoid. Although his videos are pretty entertaining and I don't want to be hating on anyone, but please do not do what he's doing. He's wrapping his elbows, he's wrapping his knees, puts on like two or three different belts just to do this. Literally squatting up and down a couple inches. Nah, don't do that. You're just gonna hurt yourself. Please avoid that. There is a time and a place to wear that equipment. Me personally, I always wear a belt. I always wear knee wraps, all right? I don't really wear anything on the elbows as often. I wear knee sleeves. Go back and watch my videos. You see, I wear the supportive gear, but you gotta see when I'm wearing it. I wear it during my top sets, during my hardest sets, when I'm hitting a certain percentage of my one rep max, but my form is still good. So again, if you're a beginner, do not feel the need that you need to see, oh, they're wearing a belt. He looks like he knows what he's doing. I should probably get a belt too. Oh, they're wearing this stuff around their knees. Maybe I should get that stuff on my knees and maybe it'll work and I'll look like him after. No. Focus on the technique, focus on your body weight. As you start getting stronger, as you start feeling it out, getting used to the gym, then you can start exploring those different options. But in the meantime, stop going heavy. If you wear that as supportive gear, it's just gonna want you to go even heavier, even more. Again, lighten the weight, get your shit together, focus on the right form. Speaking of weight, that brings me on to the second point. If you are a beginner, this is definitely something you need to avoid. Stop half-assing sets, all right? You're not working hard enough. What you do need to be doing is progressive overload. What does progressive overload mean? It means you gotta be pushing your muscles to adapt to whatever it is that you're placing on them, all right? A lot of you beginners, if you happen to see a certain workout program that someone else is doing and it says do 3 sets of 8, what in reality do you do? Do you do 3 good sets of 8 or do you do a warm-up set of 8? Maybe increase the weight a little bit more. That's your second set. And then the third set is finally the one where you're seeing it's good. Nah. On the flip side, maybe you're someone who did your set, you did all 3, but at the end, you know, you don't feel like you got as big of a pump. You feel like you have plenty more left in the tank. You're not pushing yourself. You're not doing that progressive overload. You need to push yourself enough, all right? You're placing a stress on your body, all right? There's different ways to put it when you're working out. It could be different weight, heavier weight, I should say. It could be manipulating the tempo, going a little bit slower on the way down, fast on the way up. All right, there's different ways to make the exercise harder, and that's gonna cause a lot of stress for your muscle. What does your muscle have to do to handle it? It needs to adapt. A lot of you are not placing that stress to your muscle, so therefore it's never gonna adapt, it's never gonna change, it's never gonna force itself to get stronger and bigger to get acclimated to that stress you're putting it towards. A lot of you are just half-assing each set and you're not actually getting any results out of it. You gotta make sure you push yourself enough with each exercise and each set, so that way you force your muscle to grow, so that way you force your muscle to get stronger. And how do you do this? Again, through progressive overload. And again, side note on this, all right, side note, key point that you know, progressive overload does not always mean increasing the weight each time. A lot of people think that's the only way to get this progressive overload. That's the only way to continue seeing progress. No, there's other ways to do it. Realistically, what you're trying to do to build this muscle is you're trying to make the exercise hard so that way your muscle has to work harder to lift the weight up. Now, obviously, lifting heavier, adding more weight to the bar, is gonna force your muscle to work harder, but that's not the only way. What you can do is maybe you can go slow on the way down. So for example, if I'm doing a bench press, slow, and then boom, explode up. Again, that's gonna make the exercise a lot harder because I have to really control it. My muscles are burning. I gotta make sure I don't give out completely on the way down. That's progressive overload. Again, tempo, timing, 5 seconds down, 1 second on the way up. That's a good way to manipulate the tempo. Another way, base of support, all right? If I normally do an RDL on 2 legs, okay, now maybe I'm gonna be doing an RDL on 1 leg. So now that 1 leg is not only having to work my hamstrings and glutes, but now I'm also working a portion of balance. So it forces me to go a little bit slower, make sure I'm keeping that balance, and then boom, explode up. Again, you're manipulating the base of support. If you're doing a TRX row, and let's just say your feet are up to a certain point and you're going up and down, okay? Base of support. Now I'm gonna be dragging my feet a little bit further in. So now my body's a little bit more parallel to the ground. That's gonna make it a lot harder on my back muscles. Again, you're not changing the weight because you're not adding any weight to, you know, your own body weight. What you're doing is just moving the placement of your feet, and that's gonna manipulate the base of support. It's gonna make the exercise a lot harder. I mean, you try it out. Do a TRX row relatively standing up. Now do one with you a little bit more parallel to the ground. You tell me which one feels a lot harder. Again, goes to show you, progressive overload. Weight is not always the answer. You also got tempo or speed, and you also got base support or your foot placement. Think about those things. We're talking so much about all these different exercises, but third point, rest. All right. One big thing to avoid is just overtraining. All right, what do we mean by overtraining? That means you're going, going, and going, but eventually you start going backwards because you're not giving yourself enough rest. A lot of beginners, myself included, we thought we had to work out every single day, hour after hour after hour. No, eventually your body's gonna give out. You have to give yourself enough rest, all right? When does your body actually adapt to the stimulus you put it under, right? When does it actually grow the muscle? When do the muscles actually get stronger? It's while you're sleeping at night, okay? You gotta get enough sleep. You're constantly hitting set after set after set, pushing hard, pushing the iron, and giving your all. But eventually, you know, you gotta ease off the gas pedal a little bit. You gotta give yourself a rest day, a rest week, a deload week, however you wanna put it. More hours going to sleep at night. Again, your body needs to rest. The way I like to think about it is this: you're driving a car, all right? You're going hours and hours and hours down the road. Eventually, if you don't stop for gas, you're not gonna get anywhere. You just burned yourself up, all right? Same thing with working out. You could be working out hour after hour, day after day, week after week, month after month, but if you're not actually taking those rest days, those deload weeks, those rest weeks, you know, giving some time off for your body to fully heal, eventually you're not gonna get anywhere. You're just gonna be burning yourself out. It could lead to injury. You may start noticing it's gonna affect other areas. When you wake up, you're like, ugh, I'm tired, I don't feel it. You feel like moody because, you know, you're just not in the right headspace. All these little things add up if you're not giving yourself enough rest. Again, more does not always mean more results, all right? More time the gym does not mean more results overall. You need to give yourself rest. All right, balance out the amount of work you're doing with the appropriate amount of rest you're getting. What's another good way to recover from your workouts? Diet. So that leads us into the fourth point. All right, you got to make sure you look after the diet. And by that, I mean specifically focusing on the macros and the micros and the water, all right? Beginner mistake that I did was I only focused on the protein intake. That's not the case here, right? Do not think that protein is the only thing that's important when it comes to you building muscle and hitting the gym. Although yes, protein is important for building muscle, you cannot neglect the carbs, you cannot neglect the fats, okay? I don't know why I just pointed to my triceps talking about carbs, but I mean, just look at it. You can see it's popping through. Gains right there, gains right there. And that was not just a byproduct of protein. That was a byproduct of eating carbs and fat. I'm not afraid to say I ate a lot of fattening foods. I ate a lot of carbs and I ate a lot of protein. I ate a lot of everything. Why? Because they're all important. Again, here's what you need. Don't just focus on the protein. Yes, you need a good amount. You can do the research. You can find how much is appropriate for your body weight and what your goals are. It's what builds muscles. We get that. But what do the carbs and the fats do? That's your fuel source, all right? That's what you need for energy. Look at Michael Phelps' diet. He eats a lot of carbs because that's a fuel source that our body needs to run us through the workout, okay? A lot of people, they eat fruit before they work out. Why? Because it's got that fructose, that sugar. That's what your body needs, all right? Whenever you eat carbs, it breaks down to sugars, and that's what your body runs off of for the workout. You need it, all right? A lot of you, please notice this, go into a workout carbed up, eat your pasta, eat your rice before the workout, feel the difference of how much fueled up you feel compared to if you were to go into the workout just maybe eating a chicken breast right before. There's gonna be a big difference. Again, your body needs the carbs, okay? That's what gives you the energy. Your brain, what's the only usable macronutrient that it needs or that can work off of? Carbs, you need it. Fat, again, good source of energy. We all need fat, all right? A lot of people always focus, no, I need to get leaner, leaner, leaner. I gotta avoid the fats. No, fat is essential. Everyone has a certain percentage of body fat that they need, that is essential. You go to the doctor, there's gonna be obese categories, overweight categories, athletic categories for body fat percentages, but there's also going to be essential body fat percentages, and you cannot burn that off. We need fat. Do not be afraid of it. It can fuel your workout. Again, a lot of you, if you're overtraining, sometimes it could be maybe you're just not eating enough. Think of it again, like the car analogy. Your car, what are we feeding into it? Gas. If we're not feeding it enough gas, we're not gonna be able to drive it far. Same thing with your body. If you're not feeding it enough fuel, it's not gonna be able to push as hard. So again, when it comes to the recovery method, one good way or one key topic that you need to address is going to be what you're eating. Now, we talked about the protein, the carbs, the fats. That is going to be your macronutrients, but we also need to focus on the micronutrients. Macro means big, micro means small. What are the micros? I'm talking about vitamins, I'm talking about minerals. All right, those green things that you leave at the bottom drawer of your fridge, yeah, those are called vegetables, those are good for you. Those colorful things that grow on trees and bushes, yeah, those are called fruits. Those are also good for you, all right? A lot of us, especially we're beginners, we only focus on the protein and these macros. But that's not the only thing. You also have to look out for your health. It's not always about chicken and rice, chicken and rice, chicken and rice. No, we also gotta get some greens in there. Again, we gotta look after our long-term health. If you're someone who's trying to put on weight, gain some muscle, yes, you wanna eat a good amount of calories, but at the same time, you don't wanna just overeat and just gain a lot of weight and clog your arteries. We also need these healthy things in our lives because at the end of the day, we need our health. We need to be healthy about what we're eating. Eat some spinach, eat some broccoli, some strawberries, some bananas, things like that. Blend some bananas in your shake. It's not always just about the protein. We gotta get these little things in us. Hell, if you need to take a multivitamin each day, boom, do it. If you can't, for whatever reason, eat your fruits and vegetables, opt for some type of daily multivitamin. Simple. You need the micros. I cannot emphasize that enough. It's the little things like that. And it's not just for health purposes. I mean, even just like for the clarity of your skin, like the things that we see in some greens, it can clear up our skin. The other micronutrients, you know, things we can get from, like, maybe, like, let's just say collagen, it's good for your hair, your nails, things like that. The little things like calcium we get from dairy products, you know, good for strong bones. Again, these micronutrients, they really help us out. We have to prioritize those as well. And then hydration, drinking enough fucking water. I don't know why some of you struggle with drinking water. I mean, I know some of you say, well, if I get this bottle, I'll drink more water. Some of you get the big old gallon that has time markers on it. That says 7 a.m., 9 a.m., 11 a.m., thinking that that's gonna help you drink water. But at the end of the day, that gallon is still full. It's like, no, I need to get the new Stanley. This way I'll drink more water. I mean, right now there's like a Stanley cup that's blowing up for whatever reason at Target. I mean, you getting a new cup every couple months is not gonna help you drink more water, all right? Just drink it. It's not that hard. Instead of drinking so much coffee, so much energy drinks, all this bullshit, actually drink some fucking water. All right, hydrate. For those of you who are not drinking enough water, just start off small. Maybe you're only drinking one water bottle a day, which I don't know how you're doing. I don't know how your body's not giving out on you by now. Next week, okay, one water bottle, which is 16 ounces. Let's just add a little bit more to that. Maybe let's bump it up to 24 ounces. The following week, maybe we'll stay with 24 ounces. The next week after that, okay, maybe let's bump it up by 32 ounces. You don't have to drink so much water right off the gate. You can slowly build it up and you'll see your body gets used to it. When I first started working out, I wasn't drinking a lot of water, but then in a couple of weeks, I went from drinking maybe two water bottles a day to a gallon a day. And to this day, I'm still drinking a gallon a day. Again, your body gets used to it. The only inconvenient part is, yeah, you have to go to the bathroom every couple hours, but I mean, no big deal. We all go to the bathroom eventually. Suck it up. We need to drink water. And for those of you who are wondering, well, how much water am I supposed to drink? I always opt for a gallon a day, but that's me personally. But the bare minimum, I mean, I'm talking about the absolute minimum amount of water just to be somewhat healthy. Whatever your body weight is, divide that by two. That's how many ounces you should be drinking. So for me, example, let's just say I weigh 180 pounds, divide that by two, that's 90. 90 ounces minimum for me personally. But again, that's just minimal. That's just to keep our organs going, just to stay alive, you know, healthy. If you're working out, you gotta add more of that. If you're more active throughout the day, you gotta add more of that. If you just naturally sweat a lot, again, you gotta replenish that, adding on. This should just be the bare minimum. Body weight divided by two, that's how many ounces. Earlier, I said energy drink. Let's focus on that. And that's gonna be a good segue to the final tip, supplements. Do not completely rely on them if you're a new person. All right, you should be prioritizing real food. And I'm talking about specifically caffeine, and I'm talking about protein powder, especially the protein powder, bro. I mean, come on. If you're new, do not think that just because you see all these other bodybuilders doing scoop after scoop after scoop of this little magical powder, that all of a sudden is gonna get you all the results you want. No, at the end of the day, you should be prioritizing real food. All right, I'm talking about good meat sources. If you're vegan, okay, fine. Find vegan sources. Eat beans. Go with a vegan option. All right, it's simple. Do not think that just by you drinking this new protein powder, it's gonna get you all the results that you want. All right, sooner or later, especially those beginners, you start relying only on this protein powder. No, that shouldn't be the case. You should be eating real food. Remember, these things are called supplements for a reason. They're meant to supplement your normal diet. On top of that, you also gotta look at the cost. Protein powders can get expensive depending on which brand you get. But if you were to compare the price of that to real food options, I mean, it's a night and day difference. Again, drinking all this different protein powder, although it can be helpful in certain situations, it should not be your only go-to. You should only be using protein powder if you absolutely cannot get any other real food sources in your diet throughout the day. If you really are that limited on time, then yes, I can see why it could be convenient for you to drink a protein shake using actual protein powder. Let's just say you're a college student and you got back-to-back classes all day and you don't have enough time to sit down and eat a full meal, then yes, okay, I can see why it could be convenient for you to bust out a shake from your backpack, shake it up, drink it. If you're someone who's working full-time jobs and you don't get enough lunch breaks throughout the day, then yes, you don't have time to sit there and chew your food. Okay, take out the protein shake, shake it, drink it. In those type of situations, yes, it is convenient for a protein shake. There's nothing wrong with that. But if you are solely relying on protein powder, that's all you're consuming, then no. You won't be getting the results that you want. You need to be eating real food. That should be the priority. Again, supplements are called supplements for a reason. It's meant to supplement your normal diet. Now, going back to the energy drink that I brought up earlier, specifically the caffeine. I mean, that's what the energy drink is used for, right? It's the caffeine to get you that pick-me-up. A lot of you, your sleep schedule is dog shit, all right? Your sleep schedule is horrible. You're staying up late on TikTok and then you're waking up really tired, really groggy. Bet you wish you had those minutes that you spent last night on TikTok. Bet you wish you had that many more minutes of sleep the next morning. Go to sleep early, all right? Get your sleep schedule in check, get enough rest, and you won't have to rely so much on caffeine, all right? The more shitty your sleep schedule is, the more you're feeding into your caffeine addiction. The more cups of coffee you're gonna need to get you going in the morning, the more scoops of pre-workout you need right before the workout, the more energy drinks you gotta down throughout the day. No, you shouldn't be having to rely this much on caffeine. You should be prioritizing your sleep. Goes back to the previous point I made about recovery. You see, it all adds up. All these different things are connected. All these things are common mistakes that beginners make, myself included, that should not happen in the first place. You need to know these things to make sure you avoid them and actually start applying some real good principles to make sure you make progress faster. There you have it, everyone. Those are just 5 tips to avoid. Real simple. Comment down below if this was helpful. Also comment down below any other tips that you have for beginners to follow or some mistakes that you made. They gotta let everyone else know so that way they can avoid these same mistakes. All right, let's try to help each other out. Also comment down below any other video suggestions you'd like to see me do, whether it be about mindset, motivation, nutrition, diet, workouts, programs, whatever it is, comment down below. Especially if you're a beginner and you got questions, don't know where to go, comment it and I'll help you out. I'll make a video about it, no problem. Also, subscribe not just to this channel, but my girlfriend's channel, a couple's channel, so you don't miss out on any new videos, because remember, we got new videos every week across the board for all 3 channels. For this one specifically, every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday, so don't miss out. As for Instagram and TikTok, same thing. Follow me on my accounts, girlfriend's accounts, couple's accounts. I put all the links down in the description below. With that being said, catch y'all next time.